Hi everyone, my name is Jenny Tong. I'm a GB weightlifter and a Mirafit ambassador, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to clean and jerk. So the first thing we want to do is figure out our rack position. So with the clean, we are going to have a narrow grip on the bar, very similar to our deadlift position, but we're using an arm over arm grip with something we call hook grip. Hook grip means our thumbs go under our fingers as so. So bar to the hip in a narrow stance, thumbs under fingers, and then we're gonna bring the bar onto our chest. So this is our front rack position. So when we teach in weightlifting, we tend to teach the top down position, which means we teach from the top down. So the first thing is our rack position. Second thing is how do we get into it? Let me show you. Starting with the bar at the hip, using our hook grip, all we're going to do is dip and extend. Dip and extend. This time, as we extend, we're going to allow the arms to float up and feed our elbows through. Dip, extend, elbows through. Show you that again. Dip, extend, elbows through. As you can see, this extension allows the bar to float up. What we're doing is we are producing force using our legs, and that will drive the bar up. What we're not doing is thrusting our hips forward and pushing the bar out. Notice the difference between this and this. Okay, you can see there, the bar swung out and then came running back at me. This is very different to this. This time, we're gonna add a bit more power to the movement. So when we dip and extend, your feet are gonna jump out into your receive position and you're gonna stomp your feet. Once we're happy with that, we're gonna start taking it into a low squat position. So we're gonna dip, extend, and drop under into a front squat rack position. So, we've got our receive position. Now we need to work out how we get the bar down the thigh. As I said, we are teaching a top-down method. So we started at the hips. This position is called the power position. The reason it's called the power position is because it is where all the power is generated from. We use the biggest muscle groups in our body to generate force and create that extension. So what we need to do now is get the bar down the thigh slightly. But when we do so, we need to be mindful of what our body is doing. So we need to stay connected to the bar. We don't want to let the bar come away from us. We want the bar to stay nice and close to our body. From your power position, slight bend in the knees. Notice how my chest is nice and upright. I'm not dropping forward yet. My hips aren't shooting out. Hips are sat over my ankles and under my shoulders. And from there, I'm just going to let the bar roll down my thighs. As I do so, you can see my chest drops forward slightly and my shins start to come back ever so slightly. Again, we're not letting all our weight shift onto our heels. We're staying nice and grounded, keeping the chest up, nice and slowly rolling down the thigh. A good point to note here is your weight distribution. Often, when we think about weightlifting, squats, deadlifts, any compound movements, we often hear weight through the heels. Weightlifting is slightly different. With weightlifting, your weight predominantly wants to be through the midfoot. That is, essentially, the middle part of your foot, just in front of your ankle. So that's where you want to be predominantly. And as we roll down the thighs, as we get lower down the lift, that weight is going to come forward to the ball of the foot. A good reference point for the weight distribution as we go down is it traveling down your laces. So the base of support is going to come down your laces right to that front lace in between your front lace and the base of your big toe. So this section right here. So you'll see now from my power position, as I roll down, my feet stay planted and my weight comes forward. There. The difference there being in powerlifting with squats and deadlifts, everyone wants to sit on their heels and their toes come up. We want to keep our toes nice and planted to the floor. So this is correct. Chest over, shins back, feet nice and flat, and this is incorrect. You can see there my toes are up, my shins are past vertical, and I'm sticking my bum out. We want to keep it together, stay nice and close to the bar. Also, notice here how my arms are nice and relaxed. I'm not pulling the bar in. Arms are nice and relaxed. A very common misconception with weightlifting is that all the work is done with your arms, when in fact, you need to use your legs. Your legs are the biggest muscle group in your body. They are much, much stronger than your upper body. It's going to be a lot easier for you to engage the muscles in your legs to create that force and power to get the bar up than it is to pull the bar with your arms. So use your legs, relax your arms. A good cue I find for relaxing your arms is to pull your scapulas in and relax your arms. It's very much like bodybuilders do. When you see bodybuilders flexing, they will pull their lats back, lat spread, and relax their arms. Let's try it with the bar. Into your power position, lats back, relax the arms. And then we roll down the thigh until we get to this position here, which is called the end of the first pull. Here, my shins are vertical, chest is over the bar, arms are nice and relaxed. So we put that together with our extension and our turnover, and it's going to look something like this. Now we've got to the end of the first pull, we need to figure out how to get past the knee. This position is one of the most tricky positions when learning weightlifting because we tend to want to either bend at the hip or bend at the knee, when in fact we have to learn to move the two together. So the key with weightlifting is maintaining a strong back angle as you come from the floor and as you come down to the floor. So what we need at this point is essentially for our hips and our knees to anchor at the same time, like a crane moving together. So you'll see from here, starting at the power position, we're at the end of the first pull. My back is nice and tight, my back is engaged, arms are relaxed, and I'm going to bend at the knee and at the hip. Now what would happen if I just bent at the hips? The bar goes in front of me and my shoulders come behind the bar. We don't want that, we want to stay over the bar. Your chest should remain over the bar. So there you can see the difference between bending at the knee and at the hip and just bending at the hip. So I'm just sinking my hips there and you can see I'm almost pushing the bar out in front of me. Very similarly, same thing happens if we just bend at the knee, which I don't even know if I can do. See that? I'm just pushing the bar out in front of me. We need to relax into that position, bending the knees and the back at the same time. A good way to master this position is to just pulse between those two positions, below and above the knee. Let me show you. So from below the knee, we just pulse in and out, below and above the knee. And all that's happening is I'm allowing my shins to come back as I'm bending at the hip. But what I'm not doing is, boom, locking out my knees. Ever so slightly, the shins are gonna come back and you should start feeling a nice, tasty burn in your hamstrings. Now that we're below the knee, we are very, very close to our start position. But let's see what it would look like if we start from our power position, going rolling down the thigh to below the knee, and then back up into our receive. So these are referred to as hang cleans because we are taking the bar into a hang position. So from our power position, we're gonna roll down the thigh, let the bar hang, break at the knee, and straight back up. One more time. Bending into your power position, letting your chest drop over, bend at the knee and at the hip, back up into your receive. So you can see there, as I break at the knee and at the hip, my back angle more or less stays the same. Utilize your legs, not your back. The difference is here, as I come up, I'm engaging those hamstrings and I'm getting a nice hamstring burn. I'm not just pulling the chest back. You've got to move your back and your legs at the same time. I'm going to show you one more time before we move on. Chest and legs at the same time. Okay? Now we've gotten below the knee. We more or less just need to figure out our start position now. Like most sports, weightlifting has some key stable components that everyone must do at some point throughout the lift in order to execute that lift from a proficiently technical point of view. However, again, like most sports, there is going to be a level of range and variety within those stable components. Take me, for example. I'm 5'2". I've got relatively short limbs. I'm going to move very differently to someone who's 6'2" with long arms. So in our start position, there is a blueprint for what good looks like, but that might vary from person to person. So I'm going to show you what my start position looks like. From the hip, I'm rolling down, I break at the knee, and I arrive at my start position. You can see here, my knees are on the insides of my arms, and I'm almost pushing my knees out slightly. Arms are nice and relaxed. I'm not gripping the bar for dear life. I've got hook grip. My chest is up, my chin is up. I'm not looking down like you would in a deadlift. A lot of the time in a deadlift, you have a neutral spine. What we want here is a tight back, chin up, so you can see where you're going. Okay, let's try that again. Rolling down the thigh. Our weight is coming forward, we're planting the big toe down, and we arrive at our start position. So in your start position, again, chest up, shoulders over the bar, chin up, knees on the insides of your arms. From your start position then, we're gonna come up nice and slowly, and we're gonna hit all the positions that we've just done on the way down, but this time we're gonna go up. Slowly, below the knee, above the knee, mid thigh, extend and drop. So you finished your clean, but now you've got to jerk it. So how are we going to get the bar from your chest to an overhead position? One clue, your leg. So the jerk, again, a lot of the time people think that it involves a lot of overhead strength. And it does. It requires a lot of overhead stabilization, but we don't necessarily push the bar overhead with our arms. What we're actually doing is driving the bar up using our legs. So the first thing we do is we dip, we absorb the weight, we absorb the force, and then push away again. Once you've finished your clean, we get into our rack position. Same grip. This time your hands might open up slightly or you might keep a closed grip. It's completely down to personal choice. From here, we're gonna take a big breath. See there, I'm creating a shelf for the bar. Once we've done that, we're going to dip to absorb the weight. When we dip, What we're not doing is going into a quarter squat. We are maintaining a nice upright angle. We're not bending at the hips, we are bending at the knee. An example I like to use is imagine you are a bear scratching your back on a tree, okay? So let's imagine I've got my bar here, I'm in my rack position, I've taken a breath, and there. So nice and steady, we absorb the weight, okay? Keeping that back nice and upright, bending at the knee, and keeping the hips stacked under your shoulders. We want to avoid doing this. Reason being is, if your hips come shooting out, your chest is going to drop forward, you're going to probably either lose the bar forward, or as you drive to extend the bar up, you're going to extend in a diagonal plane, meaning you're going to have to fight to get under that bar, okay? So as we dip, we then want to extend straight up. So you can see there, I'm trying to get as tall as possible. The key with jerks is to drive the bar as high as possible. What we don't want to do is just drive it high or as much as we can and then dive straight under it. You want to reserve that for the really heavy jerks. In an ideal world, we want to drive the bar as high as possible and then split under it. So we want to stay with the bar as we absorb and get plenty of height on it. Very similar to a push press, but we don't actually press with the arms. We just use the legs to drive the bar up. As you saw there, I got into what we refer to as a split jerk. So I split my body under the bar. The bar is in line with the crown of my head, just about behind the back of my ears, and we are stacked in a nice straight line. The bar is not too far behind my head, compromising my shoulder health, and it's not in front of me, meaning I'd have to fight it. A perfect jerk will sit directly above your head. Hips stacked under shoulders and almost central in between your feet. But what foot do you put forward? Well, everybody's different. Like I said, there is a blueprint, but everybody's different. I kick the football with my right leg and it just feels slightly more natural to receive a jerk with my right leg. Some people might kick a ball with their right leg, but prefer receiving a jerk on their left. It is very much down to personal choice. My recommendation would be to explore your jerk receive position to see which one feels more stable, okay? A good way to think about it is to extend onto your toes and then just to drop your feet out either side. Boom. Dip, extend, split. When we split, however, we are not just going one foot in front of the other, like you're on a trapeze. Why might not we do that? Well, imagine you've got 100 kilos overhead. This isn't a very stable position, is it? As you can see there, it's like I'm trying to balance on a tightrope. Similar to what I said when we were talking about the cleans, we want to broaden and widen our base of support. Another analogy I like to use are the little green toy soldiers that we all used to play with growing up. The toy soldiers, it didn't matter what position they were in, whether they were down here with a gun or back here, they were always upright. Why? Because they had a nice wide base. Think of your jerk as being the same. Front leg is gonna go in front, but the back leg is gonna go out slightly. Extend, boom. And there, I've widened my base of support so they're out slightly diagonally. The difference between this, boom, on a tightrope, and this. Extend, out. See, that is a much more stable position. If you were to push me there, I would probably be able to keep my balance. If I had some weight overhead, I'd probably be able to stabilize. So let's see what that looks like put together with the barbell. Another thing to note about your jerk receive position is that your front leg is your weight bearing leg, while your back leg is your stabilizing leg. So we're going to allow the back leg to bend slightly as such. Bump. Into our split position, this front leg is loading up, it's taking most of the weight. That's why we want our dominant leg in the front. And your back leg is gonna have a slight bend to it. Doesn't matter if it's overly bent or just slightly, but we do want a bend to it. We don't want a straight lockout where that heel is gonna be on the floor. Why? Well, this is your stabilizing leg. So if, for example, you start to lose your balance, you load through your load-bearing leg and then this back leg helps you stabilize. So if you then had your heel down as such and you jerked, boom, see what happens there? It rocks me. And what's gonna happen if I start rocking with a load of weight over my head? I'm gonna lose my balance. The bar's probably gonna travel forward with momentum and I'm going to miss my lift. So notice the difference between this, straight back leg, heels on the floor. As soon as that back leg hits the floor, it propels me forward. And this, stiff, extend, bend in the back knee, helps me stabilize and then load that front leg. You've done the jerk, but how do you finish the movement? Well, it's very simple. Again, bearing in mind that this front leg is our weight-bearing leg and our back leg is the stabilizing leg, we want to go front foot first, then back foot. Front, back, in. FBI is the acronym I use. Front foot, back foot, in. Okay? The reason we do that, just like we were saying before, this is your load-bearing leg. So when you finish the movement, you lift off your load-bearing leg and you're stabilizing using your back leg. F, B, I. Okay, let's see what that would look like with the barbell. And there you have it. That is how you complete a jerk. Now to finish off, let's see what a clean and jerk would look like together. Well, I hope you enjoyed Clean and Jerk 101 with me. If you have any questions, feel free to pop them below and we will answer them all for you.